Hey, Vsauce, Ben here. Last year this time, we did a video on a bush. Although that's exciting, let's do something a little bit more lively this year.
Deer. Although they might be a nice treat to see in your backyard eating your garden, they're a problem in most places in the United States, including Rhode Island. Through lack of natural predators in their environment, their population has exploded in many places in the United States. Here are some of the numbers in Rhode Island. In 1941, 662 deer inhabited Rhode Island. Today, the deer population is over 15,000. That's a 2,165% increase in just under 80 years. Before we explore the situation further, let's get cold and take our research out into the field.
Alrighty, let's go see if we can get some deer.
I don't know what that was.
Scouting for a while now. I haven't seen any sign of any deer here, but I'm sure we will. So our problem this year is the American white-tailed deer. With the Latin name Odocuneus virginianus, it is more commonly called just the whitetail. They are one of the five North American deer species, the others being mule deer, caribou, elk, and moose. But today we are only worried about the whitetail, as they are the only native species to Rhode Island. White-tailed deer can be recognized by their trademark white tail, by their long white ears, and their tan fur coat during the summer, their dark brown fur coat during the winter. These animals are fairly rugged, living in environments hot or cold, from lands as flat as Kansas to as rocky as Nevada, and every environment Rhode Island has to offer, including your own neighborhood. They are very agile creatures. They can run up to 36 miles per hour, have an 8-foot vertical, can jump 28 feet horizontally, and they are also excellent swimmers. The white-tailed deer is a herbivore, and they eat mostly on grasses, herbs, fruits, and acorns. And an individual deer can eat up to 9 pounds of this a day. Now let's go look at one of the areas where deer are most prominent in Rhode Island, Scituate Reservoir. Now we're going to go get some footage of Scituate Reservoir. Let's go. White-tailed deer lived peacefully in the New England area until the Europeans arrived. At first, the Europeans just hunted them for food, but as time went on and the Europeans began to cultivate the land, deer became more of a pest. The European solution for pests were to hunt them off their property. But deer weren't their only pests. Other pests included the deer's predators such as coyotes, wolves and bear. Due to the loss of habitat through extreme farming and being driven off their land by pest control, populations dropped dramatically. This practice was still used all the way up to the early to mid 20th century. And in 1941, the deer population in Rhode Island was recorded at 662. It was around this time that the Rhode Island DEM made it illegal to hunt white-tailed deer in Rhode Island. That, and around this time, Rhode Island's economy shifted away from agriculture, and the lands that were once used for farming were reforested. This newly reforested land became a great new habitat for the white-tailed deer without the fear of predators. And during this time, without legalized hunting and no predators to be seen, the deer population increased greatly. So much so that a limited hunting season was reopened in 1957. The deer population has grown steadily since then and even past population levels when the Europeans arrived. This has become a public health problem for both deer and humans alike. Now that we've gotten a bird's eye view of Scituate Reservoir, let's get a little bit more personal. Luckily, these past few years, my dad and I have been able to get special hunting permits to hunt on Scituate Reservoir, and is why we are able to get so close. And for a small disclaimer, we were not hunting any deer this day, we were only there to record and observe. And you might ask, Ben, deer are native to Rhode Island, so wouldn't a higher population mean just a healthier ecosystem? No.
Well, we're looking for parcels of land that are fenced off by the people at Providence Water Supply, and they show areas affected by deer and not by deer. And it's a pretty dramatic difference, but the problem is they're pretty deep in the property and hard to find unless you know somebody that knows where they are.
As you've heard me mention before, most of the deer's predators have been driven out of Rhode Island with the exception of coyotes and the occasional black bear. Coyotes are much smaller predators and would much rather feed off of animals like rabbits rather than deer. And when they do feed off of deer, they only feed off of fawns, young deer, or old sick ones. And black bear are so far and few between that they don't make a big difference at all. So with deer basically able to grow without any control, are quickly becoming overpopulated. And because of this, many problems for deer and humans have arisen. I've separated these into three main groups: deer health, public health, and public safety. Let's start with deer health. Deer overpopulation, much like human overpopulation, has similar effects, and with much more deer means much more food consumption. And this increased food consumption has led to overgrazing, and this overgrazing has led our forests to grow back less densely year after year. This can lead to starvation to the deer and to the animals that live beside them, and a decrease in the biodiversity of the region. And along with starvation, overpopulation of deer can cause disease to be easily spread throughout the whole population. And one of the major diseases that is spreading through the deer population in other parts of the country is called chronic wasting disease. This disease in deer is basically a catchable Alzheimer's disease. When caught, it is 100% fatal to a deer and makes the rest of their life completely miserable. This disease makes the infected grow lesions on their brain, which grow progressively worse and lessen motor skills, eyesight, and much more. The infected basically waste away and die because they forgot how to eat. Luckily, there is no reported cases in or around Rhode Island. But unfortunately, since it was first recognized in 1967 in Colorado, it has spread very quickly. And a way we can combat this disease is to control the deer's population. Let's move on to problems that will affect us, health-wise, with the overpopulation of deer. One of the main problems that will affect us, other than our gardens being eaten a little bit more, is the spread of tick-borne diseases. Deer ticks feed on deer. That is obvious enough. With a higher deer population, that means there's going to be a higher tick population. And deer ticks can spread a bunch of nasty diseases, one of which being Lyme disease. And if these diseases are not treated properly, they can be life-altering for many people. And now on to our third problem, public safety. With the increased population, that means that more deer are roaming around looking for mates during the mating season. And because of this, there's a higher chance that deer are crossing public roads. Now you're probably saying to yourself, Ben, there's only 15,000 deer in Rhode Island. What are the chances of me actually hitting one? Well, I'd say they're pretty high. In 2015, there's 1,085 deer killed in car accidents, which is a staggering 14% of their population, which averages out to about 3 deers hit per day in our small state of Rhode Island. To put that into perspective, if the same percentage of our population were hit and killed by cars, 150,000 of us would have died last year. Not only do accidents involving deer prove fatal for the deer, it can do a lot of damage to your car, and it can do a lot of damage to yourself. We are never going to be able to stop this problem completely, but with safer driving habits and population control, we should bring this number down dramatically. As we begin to talk about solutions, I thought I'd tell you what's going on in the background video. As my dad and I were getting out of the Jeep, we saw deer tracks, and in the video, we were tracking that deer. We were able to find where it went to bed that night, woke up, went to the bathroom, walked to go eat breakfast, and then went to a watering hole. We then sat down to see if we could see it come back, but we did sat there for about 2 hours in 7-degree weather. We were both popsicles at the end, but it was worth it. Alright, enough with the jibber jabbering. Let's get the stuff we're really here for. Alright, so I guess you guys are saying now, Ben, you've showed us all these problems, but do you have a solution for them? Yes, there's many things we can do, but I've narrowed it down to 3 solutions, in which one of them is really the only thing that works here in Rhode Island. The first being, where the state will hire professional hunters or biologists armed with tranquilizer guns to go hunt the male deer, shoot them, and sterilize them. And this is a very viable option. The only problem here is that it's very expensive. A second solution would be to reintroduce its natural predators such as wolves or bear. But the problem with that being is the density of our human population here in Rhode Island. That wouldn't necessarily be the smartest idea. We have friends in Idaho where the wolf was reintroduced, but the wolf has become a bigger problem than anything else. The third solution is licensed hunting. Although this might be a controversial solution, this is the way Rhode Island has managed the deer populations for many decades. It might sound and look biased, but I have personally seen this solution work. This solution helps the deer population stay under control. It can help the hunter with food, and with the sale of permits, that money goes directly back into DEM, the state of Rhode Island, instead of the state having to pay for specialized hunters and biologists to go out there and sterilize the deer. My dad and I, over the past 5 or 6 years, have taken around 10 deer, and those deer provided a lot of food for our family. Regulated hunting in Rhode Island is a good, cost-effective way of keeping the population of white-tailed deer in control.
Alrighty guys, so we're back. I really enjoyed making this video. It was really fun to make. I learned a lot of things about white-tailed deer that I didn't already know. So we learned that there is a problem with deer in Rhode Island that is both detrimental to deer and humans alike. We explored many solutions, and I believe that hunting is the most viable and effective way of controlling the deer population. Well, I hope this video was educational and it teaches you something that you didn't already know. And as always, thanks for watching. Although these animals may be cute, they're a very big problem in Rhode Island.